The teachers of Franklin High School are still scratching their heads over the recent disappearance of Rebel Rewards tickets, which are the tickets handed out by the school to reward good behavior. In other news, next Saturday will mark the 60th anniversary of the infamous Franklin lightning storm that caused the lightning to strike the clock tower. The clock tower hasn't worked since, which is where the Franklin Clock Tower fundraisers come in. You can find them asking for donations in front of the clock tower from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. They are trying to reach their goal of $120,000 by the end of the week.
Doc.
We currently hit the mark of 100,000, so please donate.
Don't you remember, Brad? Are you here? Hello?
Marty? Marty McFly, why are you at my house?
Well, Doc, I...
Never mind that, Marty. Just listen to me. I made a new invention that I need to show you. At night. And by night, I mean tonight. At 1:15 a.m. at the Franklin High parking lot.
But I need a good night's rest. And doctors say I need at least 8 hours sleep. At night.
Marty, this invention is my life's work. You need to... Can you shut off those stupid alarms?
What if I knew how... I'm gonna be late for dinner. I gotta go.
Remember, Marty. 1:15 at Franklin High School.
Nice to see you, Biff.
Where are my reports, McFly?
Well, I haven't done them yet because they weren't due until...
Hello, anybody home? Hey, think, McFly, think. You know what will happen if I turn my reports in your handwriting? You don't want me to get fired now, do you? Do you?
Well, of course not, Biff. I wouldn't want that to happen.
Of course not. Now, I gotta go, but I want to see those reports on my desk tomorrow or else.
Okay.
What are you looking at, butthead?
Dad, why do you let him treat you like that?
You know I've never been good at confrontation, Marty.
What is this?
Marty, this is a time machine that runs on 1.21 gigawatts and can travel anywhere in time. And when this baby reaches 22 miles an hour, you're gonna see some serious stuff.
A time machine? You built a time machine? Out of a minivan?
Well, the way I see it, if you're gonna build a time machine, you're gonna have to cut a few corners now and then.
Well, you wouldn't have had to cut corners if you had a good job. You could have gotten one by registering for the Tennessee Governor's School of Arts online or in the counseling center. I've heard they're due by October 23rd.
Doc, are you even listening to me?
They found me. I don't know how, but they found me.
Wait, who found you?
The librarians. I stole some Rebel Rewards tickets to afford building this. And they found me, Marty.
What should we do?
Run!
Find Doc's address in this phone book. He still lives in the same house.
Hey, McFly! Hey, I'm talking to you, George.
Oh, hey, Biff, how are you doing?
You got my homework, McFly?
Well, actually, I figured since it wasn't due till...
Hello, hey, anybody home? Think, McFly, think. I gotta have time to copy it, Ann. Since I'm going to the FHS golf outing at 12 p.m. on November 1st at the Forest Crossing Golf Course. And I gotta have him earlier than that, or else he'll be expelled.
And you wouldn't want that, would you, McFly? Would ya?
Of course not, Biff. I wouldn't want that to happen to you.
Of course not. Okay, but I gotta go. I better have my homework by tomorrow or else.
Okay, Biff. What?
You're George McFly.
Yeah? Who are you?
Doc.
Don't say a word!
Doc!
I don't want to know your name. I don't want to know anything about you.
Listen, Doc.
Quiet! I'm going to read your thoughts. Let's see. You wanted to let me know that Esports Club will not be meeting Wednesday, November 4th.
No.
Not a word now. Quiet. Let's see. You say you want me to come to the wrestling team's pancake breakfast on November 7th from 7:30 to 10 a.m. You say it's only $6 to come in.
Doc, my name is Marty McFly, and I'm from the future. I came in a time machine that you invented, and I need your help to get back to 2015.
What's next? A music player that fits in your pocket? Son, you've got to be out of your mind.
You got to believe me. Look, see? 2015.
Great Scott! You are from the future! Look at this!
That's weird.
Have you had any other contact with anyone besides me?
Couple people.
Like who, Marty?
My dad.
You must have interfered with the first time your parents met. Meaning they never would have dated. Meaning they never would have gotten married. Meaning they never would have had you and your siblings.
This is heavy.
Well, before you leave in your time machine, you're gonna have to make your parents fall in love.
That's not a problem, Doc. My time machine is out of power, so I can't leave.
Well, that's no problem then. We'll just give it some gas and you'll be on your way.
Doc, it doesn't require gas. It requires 1.21 gigawatts in order for me to go back in time.
1.21 gigawatts? I can't give you that much power. Only a lightning bolt can produce that much power.
Save the clock tower. 60 years ago, lightning struck that clock tower right there, and it broke it. And we need your help for raising money.
Doc, I have a plan. We only get one shot, and we'll have to do it by Saturday.
Don't worry about me, Marty. You're the one who has to make his parents fall back in love again so he won't be wiped from existence. Not me.
I don't even know how I'm gonna do it. My dad's not the type to go after girls too much, especially not someone like my mom, Lorraine.
There's a big dance he could ask her to, but he'd rather stay inside and read science fiction stories.
That's right. Science fiction stories.
Who are you?
My name is Star-Lord from planet Pandora.
Marty! I've decided to ask Lorraine to the dance.
Why the change of heart?
Well, Star-Lord from the planet Pandora said he'd melt my brain if I did and ask Lorraine out.
Just keep that one between you and me, alright?
You got it, Marty.
Alright, go get him, George.
12 seconds later.
So how'd it go? George, didn't Star-Lord tell you that if you didn't go to the dance with Lorraine, he'd melt your brain?
Well, Marty,
Come with me.
Okay.
Come on, George. Don't let Star-Lord melt your brain.
You see, I was hoping that was all a bad dream.
Where are you going? George! George! Come on, Lorraine. Give me your lunch money. That's all us boys ever want. Lunch money.
Hey, you! Get your hands off of her.
I think you got the wrong car, McFly.
No, Biff. You leave her alone.
All right, McFly. You're asking for it, now you're gonna get it.
Biff, stop it, you'll break his arm! Stop it!
Get off me!
Biff!
Are you okay?
Why couldn't I read my stupid letter? Doc!
What the heck, Marty? I taped your letter together for nothing! Do you really think that getting hit by a book would kill somebody?